How do you decide when one algorithm is better than another? Thinking about this question, it's more straightforward if you have the right vocabulary. The basic search framework we've seen so far uses an agenda seeded with the start state. Depending on where you put new nodes, you get either depth-first or breadth-first search. In a search space with two goals at different depths, DFS finds the long solution, but BFS finds the short solution. The property of always finding the shortest solutions first is called optimality. For this metric, breadth first is the winner. Still, there are other things we could consider. Some kind of guarantee of termination would be nice. But DFS can get caught in infinite subtrees. The property of being able to find a solution given time, if one exists, is called completeness. And here again, breadth first is the winner. Both algorithms use L to store nodes. DFS keeps only the successes of one node at each level on its way down the tree. When it finds a solution, the size of L is not bad. BFS adds the successes of every node as it processes a level. So by the time it reaches a solution, L is holding all the nodes at that depth. The size of L determines the memory or space requirement. So for this, finally, DFS scores a point. But what about the overall winner? What we'd like is to have all these good bits combined together. And smart researchers have found a way to do just this. If you don't know the solution, it's a good challenge to imagine how it's done.